page number 1192. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Srimad Bhagavatam, 3rd canto, 28th chapter, text number 18. Kirtanya,
Kirtanya,
Tirtha,
Tirtha,
Yashasam,
Yashasam,
Tirtha Yashasam,
Tirtha Yashasam,
Punya Shloka,
Punya Shloka,
Yashaskaram,
Yashaskaram,
Jayad,
Jayad,
Devam,
Devam,
Samagrangham,
Samagrangham,
Yavan,
Yavan,
Na,
Na,
Javate,
Javate,
Manaha,
Manaha,
Kirtanya Tirtha Yashasam,
Kirtanya Tirtha Yashasam,
Kirtanya Tirtha
Yashasam,
Punya Shloka Yashaskaram,
Punya Shloka Yashaskaram,
Punya Shloka Yashaskaram,
Punya Shloka Yashaskaram,
Jaya Devam Samagrangham,
Jaya Devam Samagrangham,
Jaya Devam Samagrangham,
Jaya Devam Samagrangham,
Yavana Chavate Manaha,
Yavana Chavate Manaha,
Yavana Chavate Manaha,
Yavana Chavate Manaha.
Kirtanya,
Kirtanya,
worth singing.
Worth singing.
Tirtha Yashasam,
Tirtha Yashasam,
the glories of the Lord.
The glories of the Lord.
Punya Shloka,
Punya Shloka,
of the devotees.
Of the devotees.
Yashakaram,
Yashakaram,
enhancing the glory.
Enhancing the glory.
Jayet,
Jayet,
one should meditate.
One should meditate.
Devam,
Devam,
upon the Lord.
Upon the Lord.
Samagraangam,
Samagraangam,
all the limbs.
All the limbs.
Yavat,
Yavat,
as much as.
As much as.
Na,
Na,
not.
Not.
Javate,
Javate,
deviates.
Deviates.
Manaha,
Manaha,
the mind.
The mind.
Translation: the glory of the Lord is always worth singing, for his glories enhance the glories of his devotees. One should therefore meditate upon the Supreme Personality of Godhead and upon his devotees. One should meditate on the eternal form of the Lord until the mind becomes fixed.
Kirtanya Tirtha Yashasam Munna Shloka Yashaskaram Dhyayet Devam Samagrangam Javanna Chavate Mana. This is called meditation. Javan, so long the mind is disturbed and deviates from our subject of meditation, one should practice this kirtan. Kirtaniya Sadahari, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu advises that the devotee should chant always 24 hours. Kirtanya, it is worth singing. It is worth singing. Why? Punna shlokasya, punna shlokasya, punna shloka jasaskaram. Even if you do not fix up your mind, kirtan means fix up your mind. Even if you do not fix up your mind, then you are still gainer. The more you glorify the Lord, you become pious simply by kirtan. It is not necessary that you understand. But if you go on chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, then you become pious. Punna Sloka. Krishna's another name is Punna Sloka, Uttama Sloka. Simply by chanting Krishna, you become pious. So Dhyaya Divam, Samagranga. The dhyan, the meditation should begin from the lotus feet. As soon as you begin kirtan, first of all concentrate your mind on the lotus feet. Not all of a sudden jump over the face. Be practice to think over the lotus feet, then still higher the knees, then the thighs, then the belly, then the chest. In this way, at last go to the face. This is the process. It is described in the second canto. The process is how to think of Krishna, manmana bhavamanbhakta. This is meditation. So this, by kirtan, it becomes very easy. If you chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra 24 hours, like Haridas Thakur, that is not possible. So as much as possible, Tirtha Jasasa, kirtan, this is also kirtan. We are talking about Krishna, reading about Krishna, reading Krishna's instruction in the Bhagavad Gita, or reading Krishna's glories in the Srimad Bhagavatam, they are all kirtan. It is not that simply when we sing with musical instrument, that is kirtan. No. Anything you talk about Krishna, that is kirtan. Kirtaniya Sadahari means that Vachaṃsi Vaikuntha Gunāna Varnane. This is the character of Maharaj Ambarish. That whenever you talk about Krishna. This is kirtan. You won't talk anything else. Savai Mana Krishna Padaravinda. Whenever he'll think of Krishna, his lotus feet, his body, his hands, his flute. This is meditation. Meditation means that trance means when your mind is so fixed up on Krishna or Vishnu that not for a second your mind is deviated from the Krishna's form. That is called trance. Not artificially. You can practice it. If you see Krishna daily in the temple, if you worship, you offer your obeisances, manmana bhavamad bhakta vajyaji manuskur. Naturally, you'll think of Krishna 24 hours, and that will make you more pious. Because without being pious, nobody can think of Krishna. Jisham antagatam papam. Pious means there is no reaction of sinful life. It is all squared up. That you can do at any moment. Krishna takes charge. Krishna says, aham tva sarva papi bhavokkhayishyami. He can do that. He can nullify the destiny. Karvani niddhati kintu cha bhakti bhaja. Everyone is bound up by the laws of karma. Jastindra gopa matavendra maho sakarma. Bandhanu rupa phala bhaja na matavati. Everyone, beginning from that small microbe, Indra gopa, and up to the king of heaven, his name is also Indra. So from this Indra to that Indra, all different types of living entities, they are suffering, not enjoying, suffering the resultant action of their past sinful life. This is material existence. Everyone is suffering, but Maya is so kind that he misleads the sufferer to understand the suffering is enjoying. This is Maya. Actually, everyone is suffering, but he is misled to think that he is enjoying. If we keep ourselves always in contact with Krishna, then we become pious more and more, and as soon as our sinful reaction of life is counteracted by these pious activities, we begin to understand Krishna. Jisham Sundagatam Papam. Without being sinless, nobody can understand Krishna. So this process should be continued. Kirtanya Tirtha Jasasa Punna Sloka Jasaskaram Dhyaya Devam. Devam. Devam means the Supreme Lord. Samagrangam. So if he has no form, how you can think of his whole body? Samagra. Samagra means his whole. Angam means body. Samagrangam. So if he has no body, if he is formless, if he is nirakar, then where is the question of angam? He has angam. Samagrangam. But he hasn't got a form like us. That is the meaning. When in the Shastra it is said that God has no form, it means that he has no material form. He has form. Otherwise, how can I think of his form? This Krishna's form is not like us. And just like if you take my statue or any other statue, and if you pray or if you offer food, and that does not go actually to the person. But Krishna's is his anga, his form, is not different from Krishna. Foolish people may say that these men, they are offering food to a marble statue. Everyone knows. No, it is not that fact. The fact is, Krishna is omnipotent. He can accept your service becoming a marble statue. Because I cannot see Krishna by my present eyes. Therefore, he has appeared before you just like a marble statue. But he is not marble statue. We must know that. If you think here is a marble statue and if I commit some offense, who is going to see? This is wrong conclusion. He is Krishna personally present here in a form which we can see. It is his mercy. It is called archabhigraha. Krishna is everything. This marble is also Krishna's energy. Bhumi rapa analo vayu. So he can accept your service from any of his energy. The marble is also his energy, the water is also his energy, the air is also his energy, everything. Without Krishna, nothing can exist. So he is omniscient, all-powerful. He can accept your service through his energy. This is archabhigraha. Samagrangam. So Krishna has got form, angam. But his anga is different. Sachidananda vigraha. His anga is Sachidananda. Not like ananda chinmaya rasa pratibhavitavi stabhijya eva nijarupa tayakala. Krishna and his expansion Ananda Chinmoy. Just like Krishna in the Rasa dance, these gopis are also expansion of his energy. And you'll find that for with each and every gopi, Krishna is there. That is another expansion. So we should not take Krishna's dancing like our ball dance. No, that is a mistake. If we understand Krishna's dancing, then we become liberated. It is said in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So instead of reading some books of this ball dance, if you read about Krishna's dancing, then what will be the result? The result will be Ridrogo Kamam Apahinati Asu Achirena Dhira. Everyone, we have got this lusty desires. But if actually one is advanced and he hears from a realized person what is the meaning of Krishna's rasa dance, then the result will be the Ridrogo Kamam. We have got a heart disease. Heart disease means lusty desire. Ridrogo Kamam, Apahinati, it becomes vanquished. If one actually hears Krishna's rasa lila, then no more material lusty desires. This is the result. But unless we are so advanced spiritually, we should not indulge in hearing about rasa lila. Then we shall commit offense. We shall think that Krishna is dancing like us. How he Krishna is dancing? Krishna is dancing with each and every gopi. Can you do that? Then how you can say that Krishna is dancing like us? If you see the picture, you'll find that each and every gopi is thinking that Krishna is dancing with him. How it is possible? If you dance with imitation, then there are many rascals, they imitate that. Then I am Krishna and I can dance also like that. No, it is Ananda Chinmaya Sapratibhavita. These manifestation, demonstration, is not of this material world. Ananda Chinmaya Rasa. When Krishna was dancing, all the gopis, they left their material body by the side of their husband, but they went to dance. That is spiritual body. That is not material body. So don't indulge in such a way that Krishna's dancing and our dancing is the same. Then you'll be mistaken, that will be offense. So, we have to become advanced in spiritual understanding. And people, the so-called artists, they indulge in Krishna's pictures, his dealings with the gopis. That is not very good. That is misleading. People may think, and actually that happens. If without being mature, without being advanced in spiritual consciousness, if one tries to understand or see Krishna Lila with the gopis, then he will be misled. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he will find rigidly, he discussed this Krishna Lila with very confidential devotee, Ramananda Rao, not with others. He never discussed with Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya or Prakashananda Saraswati. He discussed on philosophy of Mayavad, but not on Krishna Lila. Krishna Lila he discussed with Ramananda, most confidential devotee. And to understand Krishna, Vyasadeva has devoted nine cantos, and then from 10th canto he begins Krishna Lila. So Krishna Lila is the face of Krishna, smiling of Krishna. So here we have to practice to see the different parts of the body gradually. From down, first of all see his lotus feet, then gradually, that is described, the two feet, they are called the first chapter, in the first canto, second canto, in this way we must go. Everything is very scientifically arranged. If we take it chronologically, according to the instruction of the Shastra, then it will be very easy. Otherwise, manushanam sahasreshu kaschid jatati siddhaya jatatam api siddhyanam kaschid vetimam. You should understand tattvata. That tattvata means bhaktyamam abhijanati javan jaschami tattvata. Again tattvata. Only through devotional service. So devotional, what is devotional service? Savanam kirtanam vishnu smaranam padas. We have to follow these nine principles of devotional service. Savanam kirtanam and archanam. Archanam and worshipping the deity and savanam kirtanam. Even if you follow one, that is sufficient. But there are nine different processes. As far as possible, we shall execute everything. And at least, savanam kirtanam vishnu smaranam padasevanam archanam. Archan is very important. For kanishtadhikari, devotee in the lower stage, archan is very, very important. Although the devotee in the higher stage, he also offers worship, but Krishna is everywhere. But to a neophyte devotee, it's like some people say that why you should go to the temple? Krishna is everywhere. Who was asking that question? Krishna cannot be sad. Yeah, last night, I think those girls, Sarnogar. Krishna is everywhere. That is a fact. But that is for the Paramahamsa, one who is very, very advanced. But the Kanishtadhikari, like parrot, he can say Krishna everywhere. He must be educated. Here is Krishna in the temple. Otherwise, it is simply blasphemy. Krishna is everywhere, that's a fact. But where is your realization? Krishna is within your heart. Have you got that realization? Ishvara sarva bhutanam riddhesha arjuna tishtati. Have you got that realization? That Krishna is within your heart. Can you talk with Krishna? He says, Krishna says, I talk. Buddhi yogam dama dadamitam. Krishna gives intelligence. Krishna is giving. But have you got that realization? So, these are all facts. Krishna is everywhere. Krishna is within your heart. Krishna is within the atom. Annantarasthang paramanu chayantarasthang. That's a fact. But where is your realization? Therefore, you have to begin realization by archana. That is very essential. The more you become expert in archana, jīja-thāmāṁ prapadyante, then more you become realized, then more you become advanced. So therefore, for kanishtadhikāri, he has to raise himself. Acchāyamevaṁ harai jappujāṁ saddhyāhate natat bhaktesu annesu savhakta prākita smritaḥ. By executing this archā, vigraha, archanam, gradually you advance. But if you simply remain in the archa, archan vidhi or archan process, and you cannot understand who is a bhakta and what to do with others, that is also a bhakta's duty. Not that simply we shall remain engaged in archa. We must know how to respect a devotee, how to do some service to others also. That is madhyamadhikari. Simply if you become satisfied that now I am initiated and I am offering archan, I have become perfect. No, the perfection is still awaiting. You have to understand who is a devotee. You have to understand how to give service to the innocent. If you do not know that, then if you simply become packed up by archa, vigraha sevan, archan, then you will remain in the material platform. Natad bhakteshu channesu sa bhakta prakita smita. Prakita means material. He is trying to go to the spiritual platform, but if he simply remains in the archan and does not preach, this is natad bhakteshu channesu. Annesu means those who are innocent. That is madhyamadhikari, middle stage. Ishare tad adhineshu baliseshu disasu cha. Prema maitri kripopekhya ja karati sa madhyama. Ishara. By archa vigraha, worship, by shravan kirtan, by making your properly advanced, you will understand what is the position of Krishna. Ishara. And Ishare tad adhineshu, and adhin means those who are working for Krishna, they are called tad adhin. Adhin means subordinate. So every devotee is subordinate. Nobody is equal to Krishna. If we do that, then it is a mistake. A devotee never says, Das means servant. Servant is always the subordinate. Therefore, Vaishnava says Das. He never says master. Vaishnava, Das. Subordinate. Tad adhina. Adhina. Under Krishna. Nobody can be superior to Krishna or equal to Krishna. That is a mistake. This Mahabharat philosopher, they think, now I have become equal to Krishna. I am also Krishna. That is askeda. Krishna, God, is never equal to anyone. Asama urdha. Asama means not equal. And urdha, always the top. Asama urdha. That is described in the Bhagavad. So we should remain tadadhin, always under Krishna. That is our perfection. If we remain, just like in Western countries, they rebel if a woman is advised to remain under the control of the husband. That is an insult to them. They cannot tolerate it. But actually, we see in India that a wife who remains under the guidance of the husband, she is happy. That's a practical path. That is a practical path. And therefore, in the Manusanghita, it is advised, Nasriyam satantam arhati. Woman should be always protected. That is, protection does not mean negligence. No, protection means to give him all facilities. That is protection. Just like father gives protection to the children, that does not mean neglecting. Similarly, the woman should be protected. It is not that neglecting. They misunderstand. In the Western countries, maybe there is a misbehavior, but actually we have seen, still going on in India, the woman is, that is the ideal given by Lord Ramchandra. How woman is given protection by the husband. Sita Devi was kidnapped. Ramchandra is the Supreme Lord. He could have married many thousands of Sita. But as the dutiful husband, to rescue one wife, he killed the whole family of Ram. This is protection. He killed the whole family of them. Woman requires protection, and the husband is responsible to give protection. The father is responsible to give protection, and the elderly children, they are responsible to giving protection. So, we are Prakriti, Prakriti Purusha. So Krishna is the Purusha. He is the protector of all living entities. Yesterday, Vrittanugrahakataram. Just like a father is always anxious to see his children are well protected. Similarly, Krishna is also always anxious to give protection to his subordinates. But if the subordinate denounce Krishna, I don't want your protection, then suffer your karma. That we are doing. Those who are in the material world, they are suffering. Why? They have given up the protection of Krishna. They are thinking that we can protect ourselves. What is the use of Krishna? So this is called dharma saglani. This is deviation from the natural way of life, when you give up the protection. So our Krishna consciousness movement is, again, go back to that protection. Go back to home, back to God. Thank you very much. Patena pariprasnena. To understand the subject matter submissively, to question is one of the paraphrases. Tadvidhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya. Upadakshanti tad jnanam jnanina tattva darshanam.
You said that if we made a marble image of you and offered food to you, could not accept it. But we have installed the deity. What is the function?
In your lecture, you said that someone who offers food to a statue of yourself.
He's not statue, but people think statue. He's Krishna himself. But because we cannot see Krishna at the present moment, therefore he appears like a statue.
His question, you stated that a statue of yourself is not the same as you, and yet in some of our temples, such as Vrindavan, the Murti of your Divine Grace has been installed and they are offering prasadam. So, is it the same that the prasadam is accepted by the Guru?
Yes. Sakshad haritena samastha shastri. Guru is not different from Krishna. That is accepted by all the shastra. Sakshad haritena samastha shastri. Sakshad haritena samastha shastri. Rukta, it is said. Tato bhavata eva sadvi. And those who are advanced devotees, devotees, they accept it like that. Kintu prabhurja priya eva tasya. But the Guru's position is the most confidential servant. So Guru is the servant God. And Krishna is the master God. Both of them are God. Servant God and master God. Guru Krishna Kripaya Paya Bhakti Lata Bij. So we have to serve both the servant and the master. Through the servant, we go to the master. Any other question? Chant Hare Krishna.